So now, if x is an integer, that is a condition, x plus 3 is a prime number. This 3 is a prime number. Okay, x plus 3 is a prime number. This is what the question is. This is what we have to find. Is x plus 3, it is a prime number or not? Yes is also an answer, no is also an answer here. Okay. Is x plus 3 a prime number or not? Okay. So x plus 3 is a prime number is also an answer. X plus 3 is not a prime number is also an answer for this particular question. Now, x is a prime number from first statement we can say, you know, it says x is a prime number. X is a prime number. So what values x can take? 2, 3, 5.
3, 5, 7,
so on.
11.
Correct? It can
yes,
take
sir.
All the prime number values. Now what will be x plus 3? It is 5. In this case, it is true. It's a prime number. 3 plus 3, it is 6.
Not a prime number, sir.
Not a prime number. You are getting contradicting answers. See, not prime. Sorry, which is 5 plus 3, it is 8. Not prime. 10, it is not a prime number. 14, not a prime number. Why is it happening like this? Now, x is a prime number that is given. Now, any odd number, okay? Or I'll put it this way. Any number greater than 2, okay? Any prime number greater than 2 or odd numbers. Any prime number greater than 2 or odd numbers. So odd plus odd is always an even. Odd plus odd is always an even.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So if 2 is not there, then we can definitely say that x plus 3 is not a prime number. So we can find it out. But here 2 is also included. So first statement alone is now insufficient, becomes insufficient for me because it is giving me 2 answers. For x is equal to 2, it gives me prime number. For all the other cases, it gives me only even number. So it gives me 2 answers. So first statement alone is insufficient. Okay. Now, let me take the second statement alone. X plus 1 is not a prime. So what would be this? Now x is an integer. X is an integer. Now x plus 1 is not a prime number. That is what it is given. Now I can take x to be minus 3. Because x is an integer or not. It can take negative values also. So what will
yes,
be
sir.
X plus 1 minus 2? So what will be x plus 3? 0. Not a prime number. Correct? Now, what is, if it is minus 2? Minus 2, then this will be what? This will be 1 or not? Minus 1.
So.
Yes, x plus 1 is not a prime number. What will be x plus 3? It will be 1, which is a not prime number. Now, if it is minus 1, this will be 0. Again, x plus 1 is not a prime number. But this will become 2, which is a prime number. Again, it is giving me 2 answers. you put 0, this becomes 1. And x plus 1 becomes 3, which is a prime number. Okay, it is 1. This becomes 2, which is not. So x cannot take the value 1. X cannot take the value 1. Because x plus 1 should not be a prime number. So x cannot take the value 1. Not possible. Let me take x plus 1 becomes 3. Now x cannot take the value 2 also or not? Because for x is equal to 2, x plus 1 becomes a prime number. So x now cannot take the value 2 also. Condition possible. Again a prime. X cannot take the value 5, so not possible. Clear? So, second statement alone is also not possible or not?
Not possible, sir.
Yes, second statement alone is also insufficient. Second statement alone is insufficient. Now, what happens if we combine both? From the second statement, we have clearly saying that x cannot take the value of 2, correct or not? X cannot take the value of 2. So, x cannot take the value of 2. When I combine these two statements, x is a prime number and x plus 1 is not a prime number. When I combine these two, x cannot take the value of 2, so it must start from 3. So, and from 3, all the prime numbers are odd numbers. So, odd number plus odd number, it will be an even number. So, x plus 3 definitely is not a prime number. Now, we can be sure of it or not? We can be?
Yes, sir.
Sure.
Sure.
So, x plus 3 is not a prime number. For which we need both statements. Both statements to answer the question. Both the statement to answer the question. So option B. Option B. Yes. So that's what, now with data sufficiency, we need to be a little bit careful. Okay. So we have to check for all possibilities. Let's move on to the next one.
Sure, but both the statement is sufficient, is insufficient also.
Both the statement alone is insufficient, but together it is helping me to find the answer or not. First statement alone, which means first statement without the help of the second statement is insufficient. Second statement without the help of first statement is insufficient. But together, combining,
yes, sir,
we are able to find the answer or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes.
So got it, sir.
Yes.
Sir, so basically the problem statement is just a check to verify whether it's a prime number or not, sir.
That's it. Yes is also an answer. No is also an answer.
Okay.
Okay. X plus 3... yes, it is a prime number is also answer. X plus 3 is definitely not a prime number is also answer. So if these statements gives me any one of the confirmation, I can definitely say the statements are worth. If not, data is insufficient. Given data is insufficient. Now for this one, I'm able to say X plus 3 is definitely not a prime number by combining the given statement. So we need both the statement to answer the question. So option B. Shall we move on to the next?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Yes. Try to solve this. Yes, perfect now. Perfect issue. Statement one alone is sufficient. Now, yeah. Put this and show you. Yes. Now this is A. Let this be C. Now this one is coffee. This one is tea. Now, people who prefer coffee alone yes, coffee alone will be here, only this area. It is A alone. Okay, this is this area. People who prefer tea alone will be this area. Okay, will be this area. Fine. Now, people who prefer both will be this area, okay, which is B. Okay, now we clear this off. Now, there can also be people who do not prefer neither of the things, who do not prefer neither of the things. So I can keep them as yeah. So now people who do not prefer anything, people who prefer only coffee, people who prefer only tea, plus people who prefer exactly two of the things will be equal to total. Now this total is how much? This total is nothing but 50. This total is nothing but 50. Now what is given? 40 students take at least one of the two drinks. So which means A plus B plus C equals 40. So which means N plus 40 equal to 50. So N will be equal to 50. So first statement alone is sufficient. Now the second data alone cannot help us because it gives only the value of C. We don't know what is N, we don't know what is A, we don't know what is B. So from the second statement alone, we cannot find out. And we can find the answer without the help of second one from the first statement alone. So statement one alone is sufficient to answer this question. So option A. So option A. Perfect. So now let's move on to the next. Yes. Try solving this. Yes, both the data are required to solve data. Yes, because there are 30 students in the class. First statement alone is insufficient. There are 8 students who have scored less than Bhavna. As we increase the total strength, the rank of Bhavna will vary. So we need both the statement to answer the question. Good, perfect.
Yes, sir.
Yes, so now let's move on to the next.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, Kishore.
Sir, can you list out the number of formulas specifically for Venn diagrams?
For Venn diagram, I don't think there is any formula to be followed. Okay, anyways, I will explain that.
So there are those basic polynomials, so like n of a union b equals n of a plus n of b minus n of a intersection b. And those are the,
all right.
Such problems I'm asking.
Okay, I'll give you one more shortcut for that.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'll give you a shortcut for that. Now, take this as C. BC. Take this as D. It's a 3x3 Venn diagram. Okay. So now here, let me take this to be football. Let me take this to be basketball. Let me take this to be cricket. Okay. Now, people who prefer exactly one game, they are nothing but A, B, and C, which means the zones are this particular zone, this one. This particular area, okay, and this particular area, okay, this particular area, okay, and this particular area. Oh, see this particular area. So people who prefer exactly one game are these areas. People who prefer exactly one game are these areas. Okay. Now, people who prefer exactly two games. People who prefer exactly two games. They are D plus E plus F. They are D plus E plus F. Which means, which are the zones? The zones are here. Only this, and this. G not included. Okay, G not included. These are people who prefer exactly two games. Okay. Now, people who prefer exactly three games. Which is D. And people who prefer exactly no games. Exactly no games. Which is E. Now, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to consider this to be Q naught. I'm going to consider this to be one. I'm going to consider this to be Q2. I'm going to consider this to be Q3. Which means Q naught are the person, people who prefer exactly no games, people who prefer Q1 is exactly one game, Q2 is exactly two games, Q3 is exactly three games. Now what will be the total equal to? It will be equal to Q naught plus Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3. Correct? Now this will be equal to the total. Now, in any given Venn diagram, now what they would have given is, they would have given like this. I'm choosing random numbers. I'm not giving, this may suit or may not suit the given Venn diagram. So just a random number. Now these are 150 are the number of people who play football. These are the number of people who play football, which means football, just a second. Football means A plus D plus F plus G. Now that is equal to 150. Now people who play basketball is, now basketball, let me just keep it as B. It will be on the same line. So this is nothing but B plus E plus D, which is equal to 250. Now for cricket, now this is C plus F plus E plus D. Now that is equal to how much? 350. Okay, so now, but the total is different. Total is not 150, 250 and 350. Meaning the total number of players will not be equal to 150 plus 250, which is 400. The total number of players will not be equal to 750 for the reason we have the overlaps. Now, what are the overlaps? Now, just look at here. Now, what is A plus B plus C? A plus B plus C is nothing but Q1. People who play exactly one game. Now, here also I am adding B. Here also I am adding B. So, this is what I call it as overlap. Okay. So, I am adding E two times. I am adding F two times. You got the point or not? So it is 2Q2. So this is the overlap. Okay. Now here, now this G is adding, getting added how many times? Three times. So 3Q3. Now this is nothing but 150 plus 250 plus 350, which is 750. Now this concept we can extend it for any number of overlaps. For example, for two overlap, it would be just, we will be adding this intermediate point twice, because if it is considered A, B and C, A plus B we saw this to be coffee, B plus C we saw that to be tea. Okay, so now A plus B plus B plus C, okay, if coffee is 50, tea is 30, now this, how did I get this 80? By adding this B twice. A plus B is 50, B plus C is 30, so 50 plus 30, we are adding it this way. So A plus C plus 2B. a plus c plus 2b, that is equal to 18. Now you are adding the overlap. Okay, you are considering the overlap, so that's why this 80 is. Similarly, that's why here 750 is. Now what is a? A alone is nothing but a plus c is nothing but q1, and b is nothing but q2. So this becomes q1 plus 2q2. Q1 plus 2q2. That is nothing but 80. Now for 3 overlap, this particular equation got extended to this or not? Q1 plus 2q2 plus 3q3. For 4 overlap, this will automatically get expanded. Q1 plus 2q2 plus 3q3 plus 4q4. This will automatically get extended as the number of overlaps increases. Till this, are we clear? This is the way we should solve. Okay. So now, yes. So now, let me. Oh. So now one more total which you can expect from the given questions are these middle points. These middle points, which means a total sum total here. He takes this to be 80. He takes this to be some 50. Let me take this to be some 40. Okay. Now here it is nothing but people who play football and basketball. Football and basketball. Okay. Now people who play exactly football and basketball will be equal to, you know, D. People who play either football or basketball, it will be D plus G. Okay, now here it will be D plus G equals 80. E plus G equals 50. Now F plus G equals 40. Now this becomes Q2 plus 3Q3. Q2 plus 3Q3. So now that will be equal to 170. Now in the previous case we saw Q1 plus 2Q2 plus 3Q3 equals how much? 750. Now if they had given what is Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3, which is equal to the total, and if I consider, you know, none of this to be equal to zero. Okay, people who play none of the games is zero, and the condition may be if you know all the people play at least one game. Okay, and if they have given this total. Now, from which we have three equations. From equation. Now from these two equations, okay, so we can eliminate 3q3 and we can get only Q2 and Q1, from which, from this equation, the third equation and the first equation. From this equation and this equation, we can eliminate Q1 and we can have only Q2 and 2Q3. Correct? If we subtract these two equations, we will get this. From this and this equation, we will get what is Q3. If we get what is Q3, we can find what is Q2. If we find what is Q2, we can find what is Q1. Okay, from which we can solve the entire Venn diagram question. Are we clear with this or not? Are we clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, so this is the way to approach any Venn diagram question. Okay, so those intersection, those things, just don't mind it. Okay? Are we clear with this?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Yes, sir.